Top 10 worst Christmas songs ever. I believe something like that. Something like that is the title. Top 10 worst Christmas songs of all time. This is going to be a blast. This is the last Christmas related list that I'm going to do, because this is the worst one. The worst one. Yeah, of course. But this is going to be the you know, the last one that is requested. So we're going to do that. And then, you know, I'm fucking done. And then Christmas is over. So giving kids bad Christmas presents. Prank. Yeah, just fuck off, man. If you're a prank channel, then fucking die, man. Fucking die of cancer. And I actually mean that. So yeah, just fucking die. Oh my god, the thumbnail's horrible. But you know, I kinda knew that. Kinda, so. Oh my god. Yeah, we're gonna watch the video. The thumbnail is fucking disgusting, man. Is it even a human being? Oh my god. Don't look up that fucking that thumbnail. I'm not gonna show you, and you're not gonna look that up. Promise? Oh my god, that's fucking horrible. That may be the worst thumbnail ever. Yeah, now you're really curious. But yeah, I really do mean that. But don't look it up. Guys, yeah, I'm just gonna watch it. I don't have any predictions because, you know, I'm not really into Christmas. Oh, the next thumbnail is horrible as well. Poop emoji coming out of a fucking box. Well, that is, you know, another video. Oh my god, fucking normies that use emojis, man. Fucking die. That is basically everyone. I'm just basically saying everyone die, yeah. Yeah, pretty accurate. Yeah, let's just click on this fucking horrible thumbnail so I don't have to see it again. Yeah, but I have to watch this video by Music Fan, so I'm kind of fucked either way, so yeah. Paul McCartney? Wow, Wonderful Christmas Time is actually on the list, or it's on the video. Oh. Yeah, that beat is horrible though.
You shouldn't have. You really shouldn't have.
No.
Oh, you shouldn't have. You really shouldn't have.
I wouldn't put Paul McCartney on the list, but yeah, it's not a good Christmas song.
Mojo.com, and today we'll be counting down our picks for the top 10 worst Christmas songs.
Oh, Aqua.
For today's list,
yeah, but you know, Aqua and other artists like that, you know it's shit because those are shit artists.
Christmas songs that make you wonder,
those are obvious picks.
Just a little too often. While Christmas songs in general are a mixed bag, to say the least, we will be
they are.
Looking at particular recordings rather than just the songs in general.
Somebody they can hope. Fuck Justin Bieber, man. Oh. If somebody wants to know, I actually skipped a pick one day, and I was, yeah, of course it was Justin Bieber. I mean, who else?
I'm getting nothing for Christmas.
Are you fucking kidding me? Nothing.
Dating back to 1955.
If you know what that means. How do you say that? If you know what that means, yeah. It's a horrible title. Pretty sure everybody knows what that means, but oh my god. Smash Mouth. I'm getting nothing for Christmas.
Attitude to the thankfully brief polka segment. Stranger still, the song ends with someone rambling about the horrible floor ice caps melting and upsetting Santa, which thankfully is quickly shot down.
People that make horrible Christmas music, man, just fucking kill them. They actually, you know, need to have a rule or have, you know, some sort of tradition. Well, let's start with a rule, alright? We have to have some rule, you know, if you ruin Christmas or you ruin a Christmas song, will fuck up. You make a shitty Christmas song, then somebody or everybody can fucking shoot you, man. That has to be a rule. Then nobody is gonna make a Christmas song. nobody. It doesn't sound horrible. So. Classic tend to be upbeat and bouncy. Not so this time around. Sounding like it's being played back on a turntable with a bad belt or a Walkman with dying batteries, Shihik's Tomba Mene Kalikimaka borders on mournful. The steel guitar is a good idea in theory, but it sounds more haunting than festive, and some drums wouldn't go. It sounds really mystique, you know, really like they say, haunting. Doesn't really, you know, give me a good Christmas vibe. The guitar solo is very much on point. The guitar solo, yeah. It's actually pretty on point, like they say again. Which, Marjorie, you're pretty tired today. Yeah, but the riff overall sounds really, you know, summerish, if that is a word again. I did say that, you know, in another video. But it sounds really like you're at the beach or something like that, so that is a bit off. But overall, I think it's actually an alright song. So, not the worst Christmas song of all time. I don't think that, but... No. It's kind of a weird song. Aside from the Andrew Sisters style harmony, but it's not horrible, though. It's not horrible. Those are fairly lifeless, and with the instrument so low in the mix, one wonders why they didn't just go a cappella and be done with it. Lifeless vocals. That is harsh, Washmoja, but you're fucking tight, man. You're tight, you're on point. I don't even have to say anything. That's how tight Washmoja is. Well, not always, but on this pick, they were pretty accurate. Number 8, Funky Funky Christmas. New guest on the block. The funky Xmas, man. How to ruin Christmas. New guest on the block. Christmas doesn't really live up to its funky, funky title. The bass line has potential, but beyond that, there's very little funk to be found. The drums sound suspiciously Xmas, and they say Christmas, so. Like a guy from Boston with a mouthful of dinner. How lazy can you get? Additionally, aside from our preconceived notions of what the funky cover, the never really established what constitutes a funky, funky Christmas, or how exactly one can funk up their holiday. Yeah, just die, man. Number 7, Spin Me a Christmas. Aqua still thing. You know, the Barbie girl band. It's hard to know exactly what Aqua wants us to take from all this. A thick slice of the band's over-the-top Europop, Spin Me a Christmas, doesn't really have many... Aqua's so horrible. It's made plastic snow, stabs on Hollywood ideals, and the commercial side of the holidays, it sounds like an attack on the phoniness of the modern Christmas. But it's hard to tell. Do they hate the phoniness? Do they love the phoniness? Or do they just love and hate that everyone else loves and hates the phoniness? Do they not like Wham? And why didn't they key out the green screen from the igloo's forehead? Everybody likes Wham, though. They use some, you know, transitions. You know, those fucking slide bars that they used on the Barbie Girl song. They still use that fucking shit. Like... 22 decades later, they still fucking use the same old rehash shit, man. Aqua, you're lazy as hell. Oh my god, you're lazy. It's not even fucking healthy anymore. Is that Tom Hanks? Nah, that's not Tom Hanks. But he could make a really horrible Christmas song.
There's so much to unpack here. Let's ignore that somehow this song led to a novella that led to a TV movie that hopefully led to Rob Lowe profiting handsomely. Let's also ignore the overly dramatic key change, the awful piezo acoustic guitar, and the addition of a children's choir. Could you help
It's actually, you know, I actually thought that this was gonna be one of the most lifeless, tasteless, one of the most greedy, money-hungry videos I ever saw, but it's actually not that bad. You know, the number 9 spot, you know, it was kind of alright. This doesn't sound really bad, so...
This boy's mother is potentially hours from death.
Not, it's not so bad as I thought.
Are these shoes in heaven? Are these shoes dying too?
The shoes are in the tree. That is fucking dumb.
He died barefoot and lived an entire life without having ever seen shoes. Especially on his birthday. The narrator suggests that all of this was so that he could relearn the true meaning of Christmas, which would mean God put this young boy and his mother through a life of misery just to teach a Dan Hill wannabe a lesson in charity.
That's not that bad. But this, however, you know, it's kind of unfair to put these artists on the list, because artists, it's kind of unfair, you know, because Insane Clown Posse is just fucking shit, and Twizzled, yeah, something like that. I'm not gonna repeat that, you know, that name alone, you know. You kinda don't expect anything else from them. It's not. It's fucking horrible dog shit.
Snow comes with a straw. Murder City Christmas is not exactly a Hallmark picture of the holidays. On the west side, people got kids to feed.
Mom's a hooker and I'm selling brown weed. What does it now? Madrox describes himself. There was something on the cover, but I couldn't read it.
A serial killer longing to turn pro, while Shaggy 2 Dope is busy calling in New Year's Eve bomb threats. Worse still, Oxide Child is out to kill some mother fudger, and Violent J is under the mistaken belief that Rudolph is some sort of low-level pimp and not...
Magnets, how do they work? How do they work?
The narrative is also inconsistent with Santa, who abruptly switches from PCB to crack and from being mugged to trading VCRs for marijuana buds. On the west side, we got Santa the crack,
and it'll get you a VCR for a dime back. How, yeah, actually, how do these guys have a career, man? How?
Crack is fairly rare, at least in its physical form, as the only copies pressed were given away to audience members at a 2005 concert.
Luckily. Oh my god. Imagine if you could actually get this everywhere. That would be horrible.
Number 4, X-Tina's Xmas.
Christina Aguilera's on the list. I mean, that is just saying enough. She's fucking horrible. She's trash.
Christina Aguilera.
X-Tina's Xmas. Two fucking X's. Just make a third one and make a fucking porn about it, right? So many X's. No, I'm not complaining, actually. That may be one of her best things.
It's possible it exists only to grab some songs.
Or actually, one of her first good things that she's doing.
We're adding royalties on an album.
But you know, if you can't sing, there's always an alternative.
But consider this, at least it's short. And she's not wrong, it is...
Just saying. This is horrible, man. But you... You know, it's kind of the same thing, because you don't expect anything else from her. This artist, however, is actually... No, she's actually really talented, so... Is this actually Lady Gaga on the thumbnail? I actually think it is.
Number 3, yeah. Christmas tree. Lady Gaga.
Yeah, because it is a Christmas tree, and, you know, on the thumbnail. And Lady Gaga has always those weird fucking costumes, so it's probably Lady Gaga. Holy shit, she's fucking ugly. Well, not per se, but horrible photo.
Drummer boy and backed with a rhythm that'll have you sticking your chest out in time, Lady Gaga's Christmas tree may not be what it seems. Picking up on Jimmy Butler's Christmas tree as a lady garden metaphor,
this nightmare fuel.
It's not Christmas cheer Gaga's spreading at all.
She looks like she's dying or something.
Tree taken to be her baby hatch.
A very Gaga Thanksgiving.
Her nude associates desire to be under said tree, and her repeated
claims
that her tree is delicious. All signs suggest it's not Santa's lap Miss Germanotta intends to sit on. Yes, everybody knows we will take off our clothes. Well, that and Gaga herself has suggested that Christmas is the horniest of the holidays.
Don't go there. Don't go there.
Number two, drummer boy.
It's kind of predictable right now. You put Justin Bieber on the list, Lady Gaga, Christina Aguilera. Those are obvious choices. Those are fucking tasteless, horrible picks. Well, actually, they're great picks because they're shit, you know? I don't listen to that guy, but I once saw that he had a mistletoe song because Justin Bieber is everywhere, you know, you can't avoid that fucking kid. So I once saw, you know, he has a mistletoe song, you know, so why is that not on the list? But hey, it's from his mistletoe album, I think. I'm not sure if that is even an album, you know, but who cares? But this is horrible as well, so who cares? It's Justin Bieber. Every song of him is bad. Yeah, that's true. That's bad.
Already lame song, featuring a snare drum that sounds like a pan of Jiffy Pop. Beeb says trouble sticking to the song's fairly limited melody and sings.
So they're saying Mistletoe is a good song? Are you saying that? I hope you don't mean that. From who's the cover, actually? I don't care. It's just a fucking drum machine, probably. Well, no, it isn't, but... Busta Rhymes, seriously. Guys, I don't like rap, but Busta Rhymes is somewhat of an artist I respect, at least. What the fuck are you doing, man? No, the only reason that Justin Bieber has artists like Ludacris and Busta Rhymes on this track is because of the money. I mean, come on. Let's be really honest. Oh, Twisted Sister. That is horrible. I saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus. Twisted Sister is a fucking horrible band. It's fucking Travis. How do you say that? Travis died? Something like that? No, my English isn't the best, so give me a break. The Millennium Prayer by Cliff Richard. Oh, that thumbnail. Or that the green screen. Horrible. That's one of the worst videos I've ever seen in my life. That's fucking horrible. Paul McCartney. Seriously. The worst song of all time.
Aww.
Give him a break. Yeah, the synthesizer is horrible.
#6 in the UK when it was released, but barely charted at all in the United States and missed the Billboard Hot 100 completely. The textbook example.
It isn't that bad. Come on, man.
Wonderful Christmas Time is vapidly uninspired, monotonous, and
oh, holy shit! You, just look at the fucking dislike button, man. You know, the like and dislike button, 2,000 likes, 3,000 dislike button, 2,000 dislikes.
It gets covered, and despite being a Christmas favorite of virtually no one, the track not only gets consistent...
Come on, man, now you're just fucking pissing on it, man. Paul McCartney ain't that bad. I mean, yeah, he isn't the best solo artist, but, I mean, come on, man. It's at least somewhat decent. The synthesizer's way too heavy in the mix, but... But it's still kind of alright, you know? Not the worst Christmas song ever, man. Just fuck off.
Maka a cool $400,000 in royalties every year. The its favorite of virtually no one, the track not only gets consistent seasonal airplay, but also reportedly earns Maka a cool $400,000 in royalties every year. It's simply a baffling Christmas tune.
Yeah, but I mean, fucking Paul McCartney's a billionaire, so it doesn't matter.
So, do you agree with our list? What's the worst Christmas song you've ever heard?
He is balling, son. I mean, they actually had Mary, you know, that song by Paul McCartney. I forgot it already. But actually they had his song, you know, on, well, I believe that the honorable mentions for the British, you know, British Christmas songs. So, you know, what are you on about? You know, you have, you know, that song, that number one spot by Paul McCartney. You have that on the top 10 list, you know, of best Christmas songs, and then you have it on the worst list at number one. So what are you on about, you know? I actually said, you know, don't think about these lists too much, but still, what are you on about, WatchMojo?
For more Yule logging top 10s published every day,
I'm fucking tired, man.
WatchMojo.com.
Merry Christmas, y'all. I just can't say that normally because it's such an you know, overly done thing to say, but I'm just fucking done with it. Guys, that was those were the Christmas videos, that was just the list. Hope you've enjoyed it. I'm gonna upload them now, so you know, Music Fan has asked about the videos because I haven't uploaded in a while, but you know, they're coming right now at your fucking way. So hope you've enjoyed it. That was a horrible list. It wasn't that bad, you know, Insane Clown Posse, Christina Aguilera, you know, those artists are really bad. But I still think, you know, it's not, it could have been worse actually, so it wasn't that bad. Paul McCartney was number one, which was a bit strange. You know, it's not the worst Christmas song ever, but still. Yeah, but you know, 3,000 dislikes, so what does WatchMojo have to say about it? Yeah, and actually the first comment, I don't find Paul's song bad at all. Yeah, it's not a bad song, so, now the comments on it. Me too. How do they not like that song? I don't know. Snowed In Better Be On There. Snowed In? I'm not sure what that song is, but whatever. But that was the video. Hope you've enjoyed it. And yeah, those were the Christmas videos. Good times, right? Good times. So hope you've enjoyed it again. Merry Christmas, y'all. And yeah, have a good one. Take care.